Hi students, in this video we are going to see time reversal operation of a signal. Let's consider a continuous time signal. Which is represented by this. So this is the original signal. What we are doing, we are taking mirror image of this, which we call as time reversal, so that we'll get a signal like this, which we call as x of minus t. So what we have done over here, x of t, we have done a time reversal so that we got a new signal, which is mirror image of original signal. So, what are the conclusions we can draw from here? In a time reversal operation, we get mirror image of original signal. This is an operation which gives us change in the independent variable, which is t, without any change in the dependent variable, which is x of t. So what we can say over here, in this particular operation of a signal, x of t and x of minus t will always have same magnitude. Means in this case of x of t, the signal will have the value 1. In case of x of minus t also, signal will have the value 1. So it is a simple operation where we can say, by doing a time reversal of a signal, we get mirror image of the original signal. Same thing can be hold true for discrete time sequence as well. So consider one sequence x of n. I select the value randomly. Let's take this as 1. This is 2. Then I have 0. And let's consider this value is 1 once again, with this value as 0.5. So just taken one sequence randomly, which is the original sequence, I call that as x of n. We can do a time reversal to this. So it becomes like this. The axis we'll get is from 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and minus 4. So what we can say over here, in a time reversal, the new sequence that we obtained is x of minus n, and we'll have the value for x of 0, it is same as original signal, which is 1, but x of minus 1 will be x of 1, which is 2. And likewise, you will get all the related values. So what we have done over here, original signal x of n was given, we obtain x of minus n just by taking mirror image of x of n, which we call as time reversal. Once again, what are the conclusions we can draw from this? X of minus n is a mirror image of original signal, which is x of n. And most importantly, being a change in the independent variable, that is n, all the dependent variables will remain intact. So see here, all the values will be same, meaning 1 to 1.5, over here also 1 to 1.5. So I can say magnitude, or you can say value of a signal x of n and x of minus n is same. So this is a simple property or operation of a signal, which we called as time reversal, where original signal will get transformed into its mirror image. Thank you.